Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to It's Obvious Gaming. My name's Garrett Drake, and today we're playing the Neo beta demo. I'm pretty excited about this one. I've had it on my radar for a while. It's from Team Ninja, a team that's clearly heavily inspired by From Software as far as the Souls mechanics and Souls gameplay is concerned. It's basically a Dark Souls game with a samurai ninja twist on it, which is pretty awesome. As far as I understand, it's pretty fast-paced and obviously very difficult, and there's various playstyles. For example, there's stances for your samurai, your main character. There's a high stance, just primarily for attacking, mostly an offensive stance. Mid stance caters more towards the defensive playstyle, whereas low stance is primarily offensive. For example, if you get surrounded by like 50 guys, not only can you attack much quicker, but you can also save energy because your attacks take up a lot less stamina, and you can potentially escape because you're surrounded. So the various stances are awesome because it basically allows you to switch up your playstyle depending on the situation you're in, which is great. Whether you're surrounded by 10 guys, surrounded by 2, 1, it just really caters to various playstyles to not only suit what you prefer, but also to suit the situation you're in, which is awesome. As you'd expect in most RPGs these days, especially like the Souls series, you're able to level up your character and customize them based on your playstyle. I myself am more of an offensive player. I like to play defense as well, but I like to just go at them hard and fast because that's just what I like to do. That's definitely why I like Bloodborne a lot, because it's more offensive than defensive. But definitely don't underestimate the difficulty of this game, because I went in thinking the fluidity and the fast-paced nature of it just had me thinking that I could go hard and fast at all the enemies and just take them out quickly. But I clearly learned that the hard way, because I've had to edit out a crap ton of times that I died. But my patience is definitely something I gotta work on, not only in Souls games, but Neo especially, because patience is key in these games. I just gotta hold back and play based on the way these enemies are attacking me and learn their attack patterns and such, especially the enemies with various weapons like the heavy axes and the spears and whatnot. Definitely makes combat interesting every time I'm in a fight, especially if I'm surrounded by more than one guy. So right off the start, you'll see these shrines, if you haven't already played the game, are basically bonfires in the game, where you can save your progress, and you can level up, and you can make offerings where you can sell unwanted items like weapons and armors and potions, blah 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 blah, little trinkets that are weighing you down that you don't want to hang on to. I've actually have been really surprised at how much they offer for this demo. This is actually probably one of the best demos I've played in a while, seeing as its length, its depth, it really gives you a taste of everything the game has to offer as far as gameplay is concerned, customization, and playstyle. So it's been great so far. I highly recommend it if you haven't already played it. Okay, this is clearly reminiscent of activating a bloodstain and even being invaded by another player like in a Souls game, but clearly this guy has a big giant axe and he's quite terrifying. Almost got me. Oh, give you a little nick there with the old katana. Oh boy, two at once. Let's see what I got. This is my first two-on-one fight. I'm a little nervous. Gotcha. Oh, that was wonderful. That was beautiful. Okay.
Any treats for Daddy?
A little friend, a little green friend. I don't know the names of these guys yet, but they're pretty cute, I gotta admit. This guy's clearly reminiscent of Geralt of Rivia of Asian descent, perhaps. Oh my goodness. This is a gorgeous diaper we've got here. This is most certainly going to protect us from most certain death. Always worth breaking through the boxes to explore. You never know what goodies are on the other side. That is quite a big stick you have there, sir. Ah, gotcha. What is going on here? Hello, boys! Oh my goodness, that one's got a big stick and a big ol' axe. These guys are clearly compensating for something. I can't quite put my finger on it. I got you. Come on, you. Come on. One ability that comes in super handy in the middle of combat is the ability to quickly regain your stamina by hitting R1 immediately after an attack, because it essentially is like active reload from Gears of War, if you're familiar with that mechanic, where if you attack and those blue flurries fly out, if you time it correctly and hit that button, it'll quickly regain it. You can stay in the fight and dodge more, which comes in super handy, as I said. So I'm going to use it to attack these several gentlemen that are clearly outnumbering me with their massive sticks and axes and swords. So we're going to give it our best shot. I never run from a fight. I believe we can take him. Victory once again. They are clearly no match for my big stick. Oh crap, please open. No! 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 Oh, I have so effed up. Oh my goodness. I think I'm surrounded by like 50 guys. What have I done? I gotta get out of here. Ah! This totally is not my 10th try fighting this guy, I swear. First time. Just gotta take it slow and steady, you know, patience is key here, patience is key. Just gotta wield that katana with grace and patience. I think this is my chance. Oh, yes! Absolutely satisfying, victory at last. Let's see what goods he has for us. Our sandals were not quite doing it for me. One, aesthetically, they just look ridiculous. And two, your toes are exposed. You could lose a freaking toe with all these sharp weapons everywhere. I mean, what kind of fool would go into battle with sandals on? And much less the diaper I was wearing. My goodness. Man, these guys like to come out of nowhere. This guy's playing dead, it seems. Oh, Warrior Blessing increases armor drop rate by 5%. We'll take it. I'm gonna go a little more into skill and hard choice here. Probably stamina this time. Yeah, definitely stamina. The secret passage. Oh my goodness! That guy scared me to death. It's always the guys with the... Holy crap, this is not good. It's always the guys with the big axes that come out to scare you. This guy is out for blood, there's no doubt about it. Oh, no match for the combo. The high stance combo, ladies and gentlemen. If you're playing an offensive character, go with that combo. It's pretty deadly. I get the feeling this is going to be our first chance to use the old bow and arrow like Legolas here. Oh! Missed me! Let's see what range skills I got here. Let him do his thing. Shoot! Alright, there he goes. I'm not gonna lie, it took me like 15 minutes to figure out how to shoot the bow, and it's as simple as drawing it with R2 and shooting with square, but clearly, I'm a little dumb. I can't quite figure it out that quickly, but killed him nonetheless.
We're officially creeping into the enemy base camp, and I won't lie, I am crapping my samurai diaper.
I
get the distinct feeling that something absolutely terrifying is going to come out of that fog. I mean, let's be honest, fog has never been a good sign in any game. Oh, and what do you know, our worst nightmares come true. A big, scary demon with a big sword. Oh my goodness. Okay, let's take it patient. Oh boy. Oh my gosh. I am so dead. Holy crap. Ate some cookies. Yep. Well, that's the end of us. I have disgraced the name of It's Obvious Gaming again. Please forgive me. Oh, I think we found a shortcut from the beginning. Let's see. Descend, yes. Come on. Imagine if I kicked this ladder down, just like in Souls. Let's see. Yep. Awesome. Well, that'll definitely help us getting back to the boss going forward. That's super handy. Alrighty, it's time to summon a companion. One, because I want to see what it's like, and two, I'm what you could call a total scrub. Alrighty, sir, whipping out the double katanas. I get the feeling this guy is, gonna be way... Oh, Sam, you okay, buddy? Oh my goodness, you're gonna get me killed. My poor doggy just fell off the couch. That guy just like powered up a sword or something. I don't know what that was. Okay, let's see if, oh no, gosh. Let's see if we can take down the big scary demon this time. I'm gonna let him do his thing because clearly he has him distracted and I'm just gonna jump in when I have a chance after I munch on my cookies here. Gotcha a little bit. Throw him a little smoke bomb. Maybe it'll stun him or something. Yeah, I would so be doomed without this guy. Thank you for coming to my rescue, sir. Almost got him. This is it. Let me get the final hit. I think, there we go. We got him. I think my armor is a little too heavy for my character right now. I don't think I have quite enough strength, because my stamina's taken like 400 years to rejuvenate. That's kind of why I wasn't hitting him half the time. See what goods he's got for us. Oh, that is gnarly. Into the next area. See, this is what I said. This is why I think this is a fantastic demo. I mean, it's lengthy. I get a feel for all the play styles, all the various weapons, armors. It really shows you the depth of the game, like I said. It's cool because it isn't necessarily an open world. It's just various stages you have to play through. So this one's been definitely difficult, but luckily I have this companion here. We'll see how long he survives, because without him, I'd totally be screwed. So shout out to this guy, whoever you are, sir. You are saving the day. Oh gosh, not again. That was too close. I'm keeping my fingers crossed that these purple items are legendaries. It appears we found another shortcut that'll come in handy. I'll be honest, I have a pretty bad feeling about fighting this big scary demon on the rooftop. Oh, he is so dead. Yep. Goner. I am so screwed. You gotta forgive me, ladies and gentlemen. I'm clearly not a skilled warrior yet in Neo, but I will get there, I promise. Climb up the ladder. Oh! Well, ladies and gents, unfortunately, that's all the time I have for today. I definitely want to get to the end of the stage. I'll probably do another video of me getting to the end. I assume there will be some kind of big, scary boss at the end, which I'd love to knock out for a video. But I gotta say, if you haven't already tried Neo, definitely give it a shot, especially if you're a fan of Bloodborne and the Souls series. You may even be
a bigger fan of those series than I am, because I'm relatively new. I started with Bloodborne, and I just beat Dark Souls when it came out earlier this year, so. But I'm loving Neo. As I said, I've been keeping an eye out for it, and I really look forward to the full release. As of right now, it has a 2016 release date, so may or may not change. They've been making tweaks here and there, and this is the beta, so we'll see what happens, but overall, I'm just really pumped for the full release of the game, so I hope you guys enjoyed. And if you want to see another one of these, just definitely let me know, because I really enjoyed playing this game, and I look forward to playing it again, so. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to stay tuned, and join us every single week on the It's Obvious podcast, found in the links below. My name's Garrett Drake, this is It's Obvious Gaming, we'll catch you again very soon. Ancestors.